Hail, my friends. Please check to make sure that you are still subscribed to this channel. People do get unsubscribed every day. And consider, please, joining my channel membership. You get exclusive videos, exclusive members-only live streams, emojis, and more. Join the Doomcock Army. We need you, my friends. Thank you, and enjoy this video. Hail, YouTube. I am Dictor Van Doomcock, the future ruler of Earth, and I bring you news regarding the disastrous production of the Cirque du Soleil Tijuana Donkey Show, commonly referred to as The Rise of Skywalker. Around Christmas, I reported on a number of rumors centered around how troubled and slapdash The Rise of Skywalker production was, in particular, the issue of test screenings, the George Lucas cut, and the frantic scrambling to complete reshoots right up to the very last minute as Jar Jar Abrams struggled to find the kernel of corn in that massive pile of cinematic poop. Abrams ultimately failed. The movie was like a funeral shroud laid over the body of Star Wars at a booze-free wake in a dry county in the heat of August without ice. Well now, thanks to Itchy Baca, of DisneyStarWarsIsDumb.wordpress.com, by way of Scott Mendelson and at Neon Heartbeat on Twitter. We have a treasure trove of rumors centered around what a nightmare The Rise of Skywalker was to work on, and some of these rumors support the reporting I did way back in December of 2019. Hashtag Doomcock was right. Bear in mind, these are not rumors from my source. They come from a source on Twitter that Scott Mendelson deemed at least credible enough to retweet. So obviously, I cannot attest to their accuracy or lack thereof. Scott Mendelson tweeted, "This is gossip, but this makes sense because whether I like each film or not, every prior J.J. Abrams movie is excessively well made. I disagree, but never mind. He's very good at what he does. And I've heard variations on this elsewhere, but that could just mean the same narrative is being shopped around. Scott, I can tell you that where there is smoke, there is either fire or another fan has accidentally fried their brain watching the Disney sequel trilogy. My sources have told me enough to convince me that working on The Rise of Skywalker was a nightmare akin to watching a bootleg video of B. Arthur nude in Golden Showers, girls. If by their deeds shall ye know them. All of us who have watched The Rise of Skywalker know that something went terribly, terribly wrong during that production. Here are the latest rumors spilled by Neon Heartbeat from his source, a friend who works in the film industry. Neon Heartbeat says, having a convo with my friend who works in the film industry, whom I haven't spoken to since last November, and boy, does he have tea on The Rise of Skywalker. Points of note. He knows a stunt woman doubling for Daisy who was still shooting November 7th. Most of the issues were with the studio demanding reshoots, not JJ or Terrio. Also, what they shot for the first version of the film was about 40% scrapped and reshot, so no original version exists, and we won't get it a la Snyder Cut, because Disney, unlike Warner Brothers, will never admit they made a mistake with this billion-dollar franchise. So according to a stunt woman doubling as Daisy Ridley, they were still doing reshoots on November 7th for a film scheduled to premiere just over a month from that date. At the time, I reported on the massive number of reshoots, but of course, I was scoffed at. I mean, what kind of insanity would it be to be reshooting up to the last minute on a major Christmas release? Turns out, it was the Disney kind of insanity. 40% of The Rise of Skywalker was reshot, according to this source. Think about that. They essentially made almost two films with The Rise of Skywalker. Think of how this must have blown up the budget. The film barely squeaked across the $1 billion line. Are we entirely sure? It made a profit. We know Solo lost money. I can't help but wonder, did The Rise of Skywalker really make money, given the expenses of these desperate reshoots? And it's such a complete and total mess. There's no way for Disney to even recoup some money with a Rise of Skywalker Snyder cut, because the reshoots are so utterly and completely different from what we saw in the theater there's not even a way to slap together an original cut of the first version. They were chasing a waking fever dream across a field of poop, and it was the fans who got splattered. These reshoots were mandated by Disney executives themselves, not by JJ or Terrio, whoever the hell that is. Is that the name for Kennedy? I don't know what that means. Trevorrow? I'm not sure. Disney knew they were in trouble with The Rise of Skywalker. Contrary to the united front projected by Disney, Iger and his executive team knew that The Last Jedi was a disaster as soon as they saw it, and they were counting on Jar Jar Abrams and The Rise of Skywalker to fix things. It did not. It only made things worse, turning the Skywalker saga into the Palpatine saga. But I'll have more about Iger's reaction to The Last Jedi in a future video, as a source has provided me some information on this. But let's get back to these rumors. Matt Smith was cast as the original villain. This villain was not a clone of Palpatine, but an OC, and was cut when Bob Iger demanded to bring Palpatine back because, quote, the audience won't understand who this guy is. Oh my God. Bow ties are cool, fezzes are cool, but being entirely cut out of a movie isn't cool, is it, Matt Smith? Boy, the poor guy can't catch a break, can he? He leaves Doctor Who only to have his legacy destroyed by Chris Chibnall and Jodie Whittaker. Then he gets completely cut out of a lead role in The Rise of Skywalker. Can you imagine the narrative incoherence of a movie that could actually cut out the main villain entirely and leave not a trace? All that crap with Palpatine, the Sith Wayfinder, and the Death Star wreckage, all of that must have been added in reshoots, and everything shot with Matt Smith was yanked, all because the script was so bad. It left Bob Iger scratching his head, saying, who the hell is this Matt Smith character? No one's gonna know who he is, no one's gonna care. It is absolutely incomprehensible to me that a major production like this, the final installment of a legendary saga, a saga already crippled by a criminally incompetent Episode 8 that gutted the franchise like a fish on a pier, should proceed to film without a coherent script or narrative goal. Can you imagine, say, having Blade Runner and then deciding to cut Roy Batty out of it? Can you imagine the jigsaw puzzle of dropped plot threads, weird cuts, illogical motivations, and dreamlike disorientation that would result from yanking the villain from the film at the last minute? No, you don't have to imagine it. Just go see The Rise of Skywalker. The rumors continue. Every actor hated how the movie turned out. Trevorrow was not told what the plot of The Last Jedi was, even when they told him 6 months before the film came out to start working on his script. So he had to rewrite that. Oh my God. Unbelievable. As many horrible Rise of Skywalker rumors as I've heard, I am still shocked to hear that Trevorrow was required to write the follow-up to The Last Jedi without being told what was in it. This is Kafka-esque level madness, mind-blowing incompetence. But it explains a lot. It explains the incoherence of the Disney sequel trilogy, the fact that not only was there no overall plan for the trilogy arc under the wretched leadership of Kathleen Kennedy, but the writers were not even working together to improvise a direction. Rian Johnson was allowed to throw away all the plotting Jar Jar Abrams did in The Force Awakens, and then Trevorrow was not even allowed to know what the hell was happening in The Last Jedi as he wrote the sequel to The Last Jedi. Disney Star Wars is the cinematic equivalent of Mad Libs, where you're handed a sentence with a blank in it, and you're asked to randomly fill that blank in with a word without reading the sentence in advance. Madness. And yet it explains so much, doesn't it? Kathleen Kennedy thought so little of fans, cared so little about Star Wars, that she essentially allowed a bunch of chefs to collaborate on a meal blindfolded, not knowing what they were cooking. That's how you wind up cooking the Disney sequel trilogy and serve up a deep-fried filet mignon slathered with creamed corn. Thanks, Kathleen. Great job there. Good. The Force is female, and the Force is also incompetent. The Knights of Ren were supposed to have more backstory, and JJ specifically went to the trouble of casting all the OG stunt guys from the first film, only to have the studio cut their backstories. Pertaining to Ben, he says that the last fight scene was being reworked constantly, and he doesn't think anyone knows for sure what was supposed to happen to him. He says if anyone is going to drop facts about it, it'll be Terrio. Other stuff? Both Daisy and Adam did almost all their own stunts, bar the impact into things shots. All the stunt people were very proud of how dedicated they were. He says Adam is extremely dedicated to his craft and likely won't talk about The Rise of Skywalker to any media, but Oscar and John are very glad to be out of the studio-imposed limitations and constant tug of war. And please don't take my comment about Adam, Oscar, and John to mean that they aren't as dedicated. They all are. But they were all told they'd be on one specific kind of project and ended up being dragged through the ringer for months. And I think they're fully within their rights to express their dissatisfaction with Disney outright as they please now that their contracts are up. And y'all don't have to believe me if you don't wanna. I have known this man for years and can confirm he has worked on multiple films in the industry firsthand. Just wanted to share his comments. That's all. I think these particular rumors can be said to be verified given Boyega's statements, Ridley's regrets regarding the way Luke was handled, shots that Oscar Isaacs has taken, the horrible things that Mark Hamill has alluded to with his sad, sad eyes. Pity the poor actors who found themselves adrift in a film without a script, a direction, or a clue. Actors who knew they were being forced to be a party to a disgrace. A film without anyone at the helm, headed straight for the rocks of ruin. Is it any wonder that my sources are telling me Disney is looking to scrap the sequel trilogy, retcon it out of existence with the Veil of the Force, and lure fans back into the fold? From start to finish, the Disney sequel trilogy was doomed by incompetence and indifference, and now half a year later, confirmations of rumors we heard in December is emerging. Remember this the next time you doubt Doomcock, for Doomcock was right. From the center of the earth, this is Dichter Van Doomcock bidding you all, my friends, stay angry.
Ha 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 ha